Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. So today I have the Moto G6 Play and I had got some time to play around with its camera settings, and I was really impressed with all the pro level options that they have given on this Moto G6 Play. At first I didn't really think that I will be making a video about this camera performance, since you guys asked me to do a full camera performance test as well as some camera settings that I could give some tips for you about the Moto G6 Play. So here's the Moto G6 Play. One thing that I didn't like about this phone is that it doesn't have any option to blur the background. Of course, it doesn't feature a dual camera setup over here, so the other camera would act as a depth sensor. But still, being a single camera, there is nothing really that you can do with it to blur the background. But other than that, they have pretty much thrown in every pro level options that you can imagine of, and it's quite a competitor to the Honor 9 Lite. So if you haven't watched my video about Honor 9 Lite, you can watch that. So I think Honor has done a great job in giving you plenty of options and feature sets that you can expect from a camera mobile phone. So they have thrown in pretty much anything that you can imagine of for a camera phone. Unfortunately, Moto hasn't done that for this, but still, at this price point, they have thrown in quite a number of options that you can play around with it and get some really good looking images. So this video will be all about Moto G6 Play's camera settings. And if you are new to my channel, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button and do like my video if you really find this helpful. So let's start with the video on how to capture awesome images on your Moto G6 Play. So if you want to quickly open the camera user interface wherever you are on this home screen, you just shake like this and instantly you'll be greeted with the camera user interface. So this is the default user interface that you will see whenever you open the camera. And what you can do here is, I think you already know about how to capture HDR. So there is auto HDR, HDR on and off. So I'll not explain over that. Here you see three dots. If you just tap on this, you have the professional mode icon over here. Just tap on this to unlock all the professional features that this camera has to offer. Now what's interesting over here is they have given you a shutter speed with a value of 1/6000. That's a whopping fast shutter speed that I would say. You can quickly freeze any movement that you would like inside the frame. So while you are capturing any images in daylight conditions and you have some motion and you have some movements over the subject, and you can quickly freeze that and get some really cool looking images of any person that is in motion. So that's one really nice feature that I really liked about this camera. And if you just tap on this arrow mark, boom, there you have all the sliders that you can utilize and get some really good images. Now the first one you have the option is to control the focus. There is a little icon, little mark over here, as you can see, that indicates that it is the closest distance that you can focus upon. If you just leave it over there, you have the flower indication here. That means you can capture some really close-up images from this camera. So whenever you want to capture any portrait or some really close-up subjects, do change the focus to the closest distance over here and you'll get some really good close-up images. And as you just increase the slider, as you move slider up to infinity, and that's how you get sharper images at the background. So I think around 80 to 85%, if you leave it over there, the entire landscape will be in perfect focus and you'll get sharper images every single time. So that's how you can utilize this manual focus. Say that sometimes the camera doesn't focus properly, it is hunting a lot, and you can use this slider to get some really sharp looking images. The next option we have here is the white balance. Now white balance is used to get some accurate colors and accurate lighting conditions inside your camera. Say that you are not happy with how the lighting is over here and how the colors it is showing inside your camera, you can always change the white balance and see which one gives the accurate result. For example, there are already preset modes like incandescent bulb, the shade. So wherever you are in that situation, you can change this white balance. Now this is the landscape, we have some greens over here. So what I can do is I can shift it to daylight and capture an image to get some accurate colored looking images. So that's how you use the white balance. The next one, as you can see, like I said, this is the shutter value, shutter speed, or you can compensate the exposure value over here. So it goes from all the way from 1/6000 of a second up to 1/4 second. So that means you have plenty of control over shutter speed to get some really good and sharp images of any motion, any movements that you have inside the frame. So this is how you can use. And one pro trick that I would give you here is, whenever you use the shutter speed, you always use it while you compensate with the ISO. So for example, if you want to freeze the movement, you increase the ISO to around 400 and increase the shutter speed to faster shutter speed value around 1/2000, 1/1000, and then take image. It will be really nice if there is any something motion over here, something movement over here, then it will be freezed well and you get sharp images across the board. So that is how you compensate shutter value as well as ISO. Now say that you want smooth, silky looking images of any waterfall or some other movements, what you can do is increase the shutter speed value to up to 1/4 second, 1/10 second, because 1/4 is what you get, you don't get 1/2 seconds. And when you increase that, always reduce the ISO to 100 so that you get perfect exposed images. And that's how you capture the smooth, silky looking waterfalls of any subject. So that's how you capture while you compensate with shutter speed as well as ISO. The next thing that you see here is the exposure compensation. This is the EV value, we say, and it increases with 0.33 stops, 0.17 stop, 0.67, and you have one stop. Now when this is used is, say that foreground element, you have plenty of darker image and the other thing is blown out. What you can do is you can compensate the exposure value and get some evenly lit images. So this is how you can compensate. And if you know about stacking images, you can always capture three images. Say you can capture with plus 0.5 stop to get the foreground element, and then with zero stop and another one with minus 0.5 or minus 0.1 stop, so that you get all the details from the clouds here. And once you do that inside your PC, you stack those images and get some really good perfect looking images, I would say. So that is how you can use the exposure value. So being a budget phone, being a phone at this price point, they have thrown in plenty of options like this to get some good looking images. So, and if you just tap on the three dots here, you have the ability to capture slow motion, but the resolution isn't so great, but still you have the option of capturing slow motion. You can still get the slow motion videos from this Moto G6 Play. And if you are short of light, you can always forcibly turn on this torch or the LED flash and then capture the slow motion. That way you don't get much flicker as you would get when you turn it off. The another thing is the panorama, and you have the video option where you can capture 1080p at 30 frames per second. Now what you can do here is, if you just notice over here, this is the electronic stabilization, digital stabilization what they call, and you can always enable this to get some smooth looking video images from this Moto G6 Play. The other thing that I would show is that if you just swipe like this, you have the ability to change the image size as well. So this is the 13 megapixel at 4:3 aspect ratio. And you have the 16:9 aspect ratio at 9.7 megapixel. So 18:9, if you want a full screen, take the images, you have the 18:9 at 8.7 megapixel. So that is how you can reduce the image size as well. And one thing that I would like to say you is, you always enable this assistive grid. As you can see, grid lines appear over here just as you enable that assistive grid. It ensures that the images are horizontal to the level so that you can take perfectly composed images. So that is how you use the assistive grid. So these are the options and the tweakings that you need to do in order to get some really good images. I hope this video was helpful to you guys. If yes, please hit that like button. So see you all in another one. Till then, take care. Bye bye.